Quadratic formula. Make equation equal 0. Before we can use the quadratic formula, the equation must equal 0 and be in order. So, in order to figure out what order it is we're looking for, we have to remember that the equation is supposed to look like a coefficient in front of x squared, a coefficient in front of x, and then just a plain number, where we can say ax squared plus bx plus c. And remember, we still want to make the whole equation equal to 0. Okay, so now let's go ahead and work on example 1. So I can definitely see here that I've got some stuff on both sides of the equation here. So I'm going to need to move it over all to one side to make this work. So I do like having this positive number with my coefficient for x. So I'm going to go ahead and move everything over to the left-hand side. So I'll have minus 15 plus 7x minus 15 plus 7x. So then I'm going to have 2x squared minus 15 plus 7x equals 0. Ooh. But I still don't have these in order, so I know that I need to have my x term in the middle. So I'm just going to have to rearrange. So this is going to be 2x squared plus 7x minus 15 equals 0. Beautiful. So now I'm ready to figure out what my a is going to be. That's going to be 2. What my b is going to be, it's going to be 7. And what my c is going to be. My c is going to be negative 15. Okay, and now I can plug these into the quadratic formula. So I know that the quadratic formula is x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Okay, so that's the formula that I need to plug into. So here I'm going to have x equals negative 7, because 7 is my b, plus or minus the square root of b squared, so here that'd be 7 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 2, times c, which is negative 15, all over 2a. My a here is 2. So now I've got all my numbers plugged in, and I'm ready to start simplifying. So I'm going to have x equals negative 7 plus or minus the square root of 49. Okay, and then over here I've got 4 times 2 is going to be 8, and 8 times 15. So that I don't know off the top of my head. 8 times 15. So 5 times 8 will give me 40 plus 0, and then 1 times 8 will be 80. Aha! 120. Okay, so, and I've got a negative times a negative will give me a positive 120. All over 4. Okay, so then I want to go ahead and add these two numbers together underneath the radical. That'll be my next step in simplifying. 169 divided by 4. Okay, so I'm not sure exactly how familiar you are with perfect squares, but basically this number right down here, this 169, you can play around with it for a little while, and you'll figure out that it is 13 squared. So I can now say that my x is equal to negative 7 plus or minus the square root of 13 squared divided by 4. So remember from simplifying radicals that this square root can undo my exponent. So then I'm going to have negative 7 plus or minus 13 all over 4. So now I've got two different possible solutions. I can either have x equals negative 7 plus 13 over 4, or x can equal negative 7 minus 13 over 4. So this is going to give me negative 7 plus 13 is 6 divided by 4, and that simplifies, reduces down to 3 halves. And then right here I've got negative 7 minus 13 is negative 20 divided by 4. That actually is pretty easy to divide out, and I'll get negative 5. So there's my two possible solutions for x. 3 halves or negative 5. Okay, so let's go ahead and take a look at our next example. So this next example is 3x squared plus 5x plus 2 equals 7. So, in order to solve that, we first want to get everything over to the same side of the equation so that we can say everything is set equal to 0. So now I've got 3x squared plus 5x minus 5 equals 0. Then I want to plug this into the quadratic formula, which is x equals negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over 2a. Okay, cool. So, yep, everything nice, simple order over here. My a is going to be equal to 3, my b is going to be equal to 5, and my c is going to be equal to negative 5. So now I'm ready to plug in, and I'm going to have x equals negative b, negative 5, plus or minus the square root of b squared, 5 squared, minus 4 times a, which is 3, times c, which is negative 5, all over 2a, which is 3. Okay, so now I'm going to start doing some simplifying. X equals negative 5 plus or minus the square root of 25. And then negative 4 times 3 will give me negative 12. Negative 12 times negative 5 will give me positive 60. Divided by 2 times 3 is 6. I can go ahead and combine one more thing right here, and I'll have plus or minus the square root of 85 all over 6. So this 85 right here, it's not popping out as a nice square number, but I might still be able to reduce this radical if I try to do some prime factorization. So I know that this is divisible by 5, and 5 goes into 85 17 times. So I could say that the square root of 85 is equal to the square root of 5 times the square root of 17. But I'm not getting anything over here that I can say is something squared, so I'm not going to be able to use my radical to undo that exponent. So I'm not going to be able to simplify my expression any farther, and this right here is going to be my final answer.